Alright guys, I'm Lurker101 and this is Let's Play Tomb Raider First Blood. I know what you're thinking straight away, First Blood, it's not First Blood. It's Tomb Raider 2013 or Tomb Raider Reboot or Reloaded or whatever. No. Go watch the old Rambo movies, the first three. If you haven't got them, ask your father for their VHSs of them. I know you don't know what a VHS is. Ask your parents, they'll tell you, they'll show you. Go on to Hulu, Netflix, whatever. Watch the first three Rambo movies, you'll understand exactly what I mean. If you can't be bothered to watch the first three Rambo movies, don't worry. The story writers for this have watched the fuck out of those movies. This Let's Play has been inspired by Naughty Lamb's playthrough, which captivated me, it really did. She did an amazing job, I wanted to do one myself. That's what I'm doing it, here we go. The version I've got is... It was a great big bundle. Deal on Steam, so I just bought it down. Why not? Got bundled with a lot of multiplayer stuff, which is about as useful to me as fake tits on a zombie. Doesn't matter. New game, create a new save, normal. And we're in there.
A famous explorer once said that the extraordinary is in what we do, not who we are. I finally set out to make my mark. To find adventure, but instead, adventure found me. In our darkest moments. When life flashes before us, we find something. Something that keeps us going. Something that pushes us.
Well, that's one brilliant intro, and straight away, first gripe, the subtitles really, really remind us of the old BBC teletext subtitles. It's just... We have to do subtitles, and that is not the right way. That is horrible. Yeah, you probably got to hear me complaining. When I initially saw this game, I thought I would hate the hell out of it, but... Kind of like Resident Evil 4 in that respect that I thought I'd hate it. I started playing it and I really, really enjoy it. As you expect from me, we've got all the top back settings. Your stupid Triss FX hair. Ultra textures, blah, blah, blah. So here we are, poor little llama, hung upside down. And... if you're fond of quick time events, you really got to try this game. It is a quick time event extravaganza.
Help! Jonah!
first puzzle, nice and simple. Swing! Bit of momentum. Momentum!
Got to get down.
Let's get a bit of fire. Come on, swing the way you meant to, darling. It's not that difficult.
This is going to hurt.
You have no idea. The rest of us know what's going to happen in 3 seconds. Sorry, 8 seconds time. 6, 7, 8. And there's your first glimmer of Rambo. On a happy note, they really know how to do the pain effects and whatnot, because that does, you're looking at it, you're feeling it, you're saying, oh, that is horrible.
Oh God, no, no, no. What is this place?
Well, first, you're the archaeologist and whatnot, you should know this is a shrine of sorts.
What happened to you?
Spoiler alert, I think she died a bit. Cause of death, she stopped living.
A torch. That was loud.
Yes, it was. I hear voices. Did you hear them too? Mine and Laura's door count. It wasn't normal. Kinda. Here we are, through a spooky cave.
No, we must have
heard. She heard him too! I'm not going crazy after all. Very, very simple puzzle here. Here's fire. Oh. Jump down, jump down, jump down. Don't really need to jump down. My memory on this won't really go so far back as the last mini episode, which really crapped out. Get off, get off! I am not a sexual animal! No! All you need for this scene now is a load of rats climbing across her, and you've got that mine scene from Rambo 1. Just saying. But yeah, my memory only goes so far forward, so there will be a point where I'm stumbling around in the dark, not a clue what I'm doing, which will make this infinitely more fun.
I need to find a way out. More fire. Thank God.
Right. Let's get this puzzle done.
What kind of contraption is this?
Do that. And the other one. Can you tell what it is yet? Oh, there's something wrong with you. Right. Run and up! We did that for reasons. I'm not getting feet wet. Screw that. It's cold there, she's gotta get an infection. That injury does not look pleasant. Whoa! Didn't mean to do that, didn't mean to do it. Come on, let's whack about a bit. Come on, let's grab it and take the tool. I didn't think I was going to make it there. But I did. What team rings on. And shove!
I've got to get out of here.
Oh yeah. This is what hurt her. This is hurting her. This is not pleasant. That 5 minutes in this is absolutely gorgeous.
Move over.
Intense opening scene, and here we are at the benchmark cinematic. Just look at that. That's the sort of stunning vista that you will experience throughout the game. That is wallpaper material right there. Lara, get your camera out, take a picture, stick that on your desktop. Use the blade as a ladder. Like a genius. This game does a really, really nice job of tutorializing all the buttons, all elements. Sometimes to the point of all the kill buttons, the main thing is really pays off. Basically, if you're stumbling around, not knowing how to use an item, don't really know how to do a certain thing, it's your fault. Just do what you can to show you how to do it. I know there's a lot of talk about Lurker101 narrative dissonance, and yeah, sometimes it gets a bit silly, but the same, I don't really care.
Sounds pack.
This game is fun.
this way.
Most people. Concussed at least. At least the weather sucks. That cold put a bloody sweater on her. Oh yeah, what about on him, yeah.
Looks abandoned. Is anyone listening? Please respond.
I wish the camera would stop trying to look down at all. I know there's part of it with a male audience, but that is... that's frustrating. It makes any effort on my part to make lewd comments rather than moot. It's... pick and roll hanging fruit now. And if this was me, you, or anybody else, one last match, you can guarantee the match would snap, would drop it, a droplet of rain would hit the flame, anything, we would not get that lucky.
Here's the soon-to-be world-famous archaeologist, Lara Croft, in her native habitat. She's on the hunt for the lost kingdom of Yamatai, home to the fabulous Himiko, mythical sun queen, and ancestor of yours truly.
Sam, this is serious.
Oh, sweetie, I know. I'm just trying to lighten the mood here. Everyone's so on edge. What are you so worried about?
I'm close to something. I'm sure of it. I just don't know if the others will listen. Or even if they should.
Lara, you know this stuff better than anyone. Seriously, I'm not just saying this to make you feel better. I trust you, Roth trusts you. You got this. Now let's take a break, okay?
Okay, okay. And Sam, thanks.
She's not always this serious, you know?
How can you suggest I'm not serious about this expedition, Lara? It's not just Sam's family funding us. I put my savings on the line, too.
We've all got some kind of stake in this. The funding won't last forever, Whitman.
That's precisely why we should push east, not west.
No one believes Yamatai is that far east. The books simply don't support it.
Well, whoever wrote those books never found Yamatai.
I've talked to Roth about this. There's no point in following in other people's footsteps, Dr. Whitman.
I refuse to bet my reputation on your hunch. I'm the lead archaeologist here.
And when were you last in the field without a TV crew behind you?
Got 30 years experience, 2 PhDs, 1 in East Asian history. So why don't you just stick to boats, Mr. Grimm?
Ship, Dr. Whitman. It's a ship. Don't need a PhD to know
Look,
that.
Going east will take us directly into the Dragon's Triangle. That's where we need to go.
Lara, my little bird. I'd follow you almost anywhere, but that place has a bad energy.
Bad storms, more like, makes the Bermuda Triangle look like Disney World. Sign me up.
The stories about Queen Himiko say she could summon storms. Myths are usually based on some version of the truth. What if Yamatai was somewhere in the triangle itself?
Well, look, this is the satellite imagery from inside the Dragon's Triangle.
That doesn't look good.
If it's wet, I can sail on it.
Oh, don't tell me you're seriously
Reyes is right. We don't have the funds to piss about. It's now or never. Lara's offering fresh ideas and a plan. I'm the captain here. It's my decision. We're going into the Dragon's Triangle.
Why am I even here?
So yeah, that's how they characterize the cast and crew. Personally, I think it's a really nice way to do it. And I think we'll call this the end of this chapter. Once the cutscene ends, obviously.
I can't just sit here.
Next time, we'll do Woman versus Wild. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you're enjoying it. And we'll see you next time. Goodbye.